Después del seminario público organizado por el Consejo Directivo de la Comisión de Cooperación Ecológica Fronteriza y el Banco de Desarrollo de América del Norte en la ciudad de Washington el pasado miércoles 3 de diciembre, se llevó a cabo una recepción especial en la sala de efectivo del Departamento del Tesoro de los Estados Unidos para conmemorar el vigésimo aniversario de las dos instituciones. El evento, que tuvo lugar por la noche, se vio engalanado con la participación de invitados especiales como Marisa Lago, subsecretaria de Mercados Internacionales y Desarrollo del Departamento del Tesoro de Estados Unidos, quien dirigió unas palabras de bienvenida y presentó al secretario del Departamento del Tesoro, Jacob Yellow. Asimismo, se contó con la presencia de Fernando Aportela, subsecretario de Hacienda y Crédito Público de México, y del embajador de México en Estados Unidos, Eduardo Medina Mora. Todos ellos subrayaron la especial relación que existe entre los dos países y el impacto que ambas instituciones han tenido en la región fronteriza. El secretario Lu felicitó a los administradores de la COSEF y el BEDAN por su exitosa reunión de consejo y agradeció a los subsecretarios Aportela y Sergio Alcocer por su distinguida presencia en representación de la delegación mexicana en este evento.
Let me say what an honor it is to have everyone here today to mark the 20th anniversary of the North American Development Bank and the Border Environment Cooperation Commission. These binational institutions demonstrate the profound difference our two nations can make in the lives of our people when we work together. The fact is that for more than two decades, our investments in these institutions have helped strengthen communities along our border and have achieved lasting results for millions.
Agregó que la aprobación del Tratado de Libre Comercio de América del Norte creó una alianza económica transformacional y perdurable.
Of course, when NAFTA was being designed and built two decades ago, it would have been easy for leaders in both our countries to focus only on igniting cross-border trade, commerce, and investment. It would have been easy for them to set their sights only on the powerful benefits that come from opening markets and increasing competition. But they did not. The United States and Mexico put institutions in place to work together to protect the environment and to invest in communities near our borders. That's why the North American Development Bank and the Border Environment Cooperation Commission were started, to work hand in hand to enhance conditions on both sides of the U.S.-Mexico border. Through these institutions, the United States and Mexico have jointly taken action to raise living standards and environmental quality across the important border region. Our investments have helped set in motion the rapid development of renewable energy sectors in the region, with wind and solar energy projects pioneering, powering local economies in both Mexico and the United States.
Si bien los logros alcanzados por ambas instituciones son importantes, concluyó el secretario Liu, todavía hay más trabajo por hacer.
Families across the region still lack access to clean water and sanitation, and there's tremendous unmet potential in emerging sectors such as green infrastructure. As we look ahead, it's important to note that this is a historic moment, not only in terms of celebrating the beginning of the NAD Bank and the BEC, but also in terms of their ongoing evolution. The board just voiced support for a merger of these two institutions. And this consolidation will allow the United States and Mexico to support the border region even more effectively and efficiently.
El subsecretario Aportela, al hablar sobre la colaboración entre los dos países, mencionó:
We have been having this very strong relationship with, between the Treasury and the Secretaría de Hacienda. And as Marisa mentioned, we have achieved great things from the IDB, to TPP, and now with the NAD Bank and BEC. And it has been very interesting times in which we have the unique opportunity that the management actually presented a fusion of two different institutions without any hassle, and they come up together with saying, you know, we can do better. We have opportunities and we have challenges, and we will be more prepared to grab those opportunities and to face those challenges if we are together, if we combine our efforts.
El embajador Medina Mora habló sobre los resultados de las negociaciones realizadas en el marco del TLCAN, incluyendo la resolución de las inquietudes relacionadas con la calidad del medio ambiente.
We negotiated the environmental side agreement. I was actually part of the negotiation from the private sector, the North American Agreement on Environmental Cooperation, and establish the BEC and the NatBank with a mandate to oversee and provide financing to environmentally related projects along the border. Despite NatBank's political origin and the joke during the first years of operation that was that it was really the Nada Bank and would be the Nothing Bank. But it has been proven a success. And here I think it's only right to pay tribute and to remember NatBank's first managing director, a dear friend, the late Alfredo Phillips Olmedo, who launched it in the right direction during its critical first years of existence. NAFTA has been an unquestionable success, best reflected in the fact that we not only trade intensively with each other, but we produce goods jointly through very effectively integrated regional production and supply chains that have developed as a result of the clear, stable, and transparent rules established by NAFTA. Yet, there is much that still needs to be done, and the BEC and NatBank now jointly have a critical role to play.
Durante la recepción, también se presentó el video titulado Dos décadas de resultados, que puso de relieve algunos de los 243 proyectos que han sido certificados por la COSEF y el BEDAN desde 1994. Entre los más destacados logros en estos 20 años de servicio se cuentan 21 plantas potabilizadoras, 40 sistemas de distribución de agua potable, 61 plantas de tratamiento de aguas residuales, 99 sistemas de alcantarillado, 26 proyectos de conservación de agua, 16 rellenos sanitarios municipales construidos o ampliados, 12 tiraderos clausurados, 9 millones de metros cuadrados pavimentados, 1,450 megawatts AC de nueva capacidad de generación de energía renovable. Para más detalles sobre estos logros y los 243 proyectos certificados, se pueden consultar los portales electrónicos www.becc.org y www.nadb.org.